Okay, and welcome to Intermediate Accounting After Dark. This is Tchaikovsky, and I'm doing a couple questions here. Our first one is going to be exercise 4-4. So here we have a question asking us for a single step income statement. What does that mean? We're going to be looking at net revenues less our expenses. We'll be giving us our net income before income taxes. Less our income taxes gives us net income. This is different than a traditional multi-step income statement, which is sales minus our cost of goods sold gives us our gross profit, which less SG&A is going to be giving us our operating income, plus or minus other expenses will be giving us our net income before tax. But let's go through and take a look here. So the financial records of Leroy Jones were destroyed by fire at the end of 2020. I promise I didn't set that fire, although I kind of want to after reading this question. Fortunately, the controller had kept certain statistical data related to the income statement as follows. So here we've got some data here about the beginning merchandise inventory. We've got some sales discounts. We've got shares of stock, interest expense, income tax rate, cost of goods sold, administrative expenses, 4/5 of operating expenses. And then here, we're asked to prepare an income statement for the year 2020 in single step form. So the first thing I'm gonna need to figure out is gonna be my sales, right? What are my total sales? Okay, and if I go through and I kind of read this question, it's giving me a hint here. It says that administrative expenses are 20% of cost of goods sold, but only 8% of gross sales. So if we look here at our single step income statement, which is gonna essentially be sales less my expenses, which will ultimately be giving my net income before income tax, less income taxes, and this will be giving here my net income after tax. So if I look at this first clue here, which is administrative expenses are 20% of cost of goods sold, but only 8% of gross sales. If I see here, well, if admin expenses are 20% of cost of goods sold, what this means is that, well, 500,000, which are my cost of goods sold, times 20%, it's going to give me 100,000. So 100,000 is going to be equal to my administrative expenses. Okay. So I know that's a little bit challenging to kind of see, but again, I have to, they're not giving me sales. They give me sales discounts, but they're not telling me what my sales are directly. But they do tell me that administrative expenses are 20% of cost of goods sold, but only 8% of gross sales. So my administrative expenses are kind of my key. So at 20% of cost of goods sold, I'm multiplying that 20% by 500,000, getting to the 100,000. So $100,000 will be my administrative expenses. But now it says my administrative expenses are only 8% of gross sales. So my gross sales times 8% is gonna be my administrative expenses of 100,000. So my gross sales must be equal to 100,000 divided by 0.08. So if I go through and look at this here, I'm getting my gross sales. So my total sales here are gonna be 1,250,000. So again, this is a weird question because right over here, it's saying that it's not telling me what my sales are. Rather, I have to go through and back into it. One of the interesting things about this question is that I'll kind of come back. There's some information here that you don't even need. So, and I'll kind of come back to that a little bit later, but let's just keep going through the question. So to get to my net sales, what I need to go through and do is I need to take my gross sales, which I just figured out right here as 1,250,000. And now what I need to go through and do is basically figure out, well, what are my net sales? Well, if remember before that when we're looking at sales, it's going to be sales minus sales returns, minus sales discounts, and minus any sales allowances. Those are what we call contra revenue accounts. So this is going to be less in this case right here. We had sales discounts. So this is right here, sales discounts. So my net sales are going to be $1,233,000. Okay, so I've dealt with this. Shares of common stock, I'm going to show how that works a little bit later. Interest expense, that is going to be one of our expenses. Now, because we're doing a single step income statement, I'm just going to group it with an expense. If I was doing a multi-step income statement, I would be showing that as other income or expense. So I've got interest expense here of $20,000. Okay, the income tax rate, we're going to be using that a little bit later. And then it says here, cost of goods sold is going to be $500,000. Okay. Now, after I get to this cost of goods sold, I just figured out my administrative expenses. My administrative expenses, I figured these out, and these were $100,000. So I figured out those administrative expenses from my computation basically up here is to get my total amount of my sales. Okay, so now I've got my administrative expenses. Now, this is the one that messed me up. I also had to look at the answer key. But it says that 4/5 of the operating expenses relate to sales activities. Now, what are operating expenses? That means SG&A, okay? Interest expense is not SG&A, okay? That's other income, okay? Other income expense. It's not something we're doing as part of our operations. Cost of goods sold is not SG&A, right? Those are product costs that we're going through and expensing. The administrative expenses rather represent, this is SG&A. So what this is saying here is that 4/5 of the operating expenses, which is this one right here, okay, relate to sales activity. This must mean that this 100,000 represented 1/5 of the operating expenses. So when I look at this, my total operating expenses are going to be 500,000, okay? So again, it tells me that 4/5 of the operating expenses were related to sales activities. Now the challenge here is that I know, well, hey, admit of these expenses here, only administrative expenses are part of operating. So if 4/5 relate to sales, then 1/5 must have related to administrative. So what I'm doing here is I'm saying, well, 1/5 times the operating expenses gives me $100,000. So therefore, solving for X, the total operating expenses must have been 500,000. Now, if my total operating expenses are 500,000, and I multiply this by the 4/5, I get my total sales, basically my sales expenses are right here. So right over here, my next operating expense, so my sales expenses, okay, is gonna be 400,000, okay? All right, so right over here, 400,000, okay? So my total expenses are going to be 20,000 plus the 500 plus the 100 plus the 400 are 1,020,000. So my net income before income taxes is going to be 213,000, okay? So my income taxes right here, it says that the income tax is 30%. So when I come over here, my net basically less my income taxes. This is going to be 30% of 213,000. Okay, so my net income after tax is going to be $149,100. So this is essentially the single step income statement we're being asked to prepare. And the other thing I would need to do is right over here is Leroy Jones. Not racist. I didn't say it, the book did. This is Wiley. Income statement. Right here for the year ended 12/31/20. Okay. I think that's right. Okay. So this gives us our net income after tax. The next thing I need to do though is when I'm looking at any proper income statement is I need to come up with earnings per share. And so the last thing I'm going to go through and do is that what is earnings per share? Well, the short answer is it's going to be net income, right, divided by the number, the average number of shares outstanding. However, the real computation for earnings per share is a little bit more complicated because we need to deduct things like preferred dividends and the like, but this question is relatively straightforward. So here we're going to have our net income after tax, which is going to be $149,000. We're going to be dividing this by my average common shares outstanding, which is going to be 20,000. And so then right here, my earnings per share for this particular company is going to be 149,000 divided by 20,000, and I get $7.46. So this is exercise 4-4. I hope you have enjoyed watching this unlisted illegal video today. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I will see you on the next video. Have a great one.